Thank you very much for coming out tonight. My name is Ian Henderson. This is my final DMA recital. It's pretty hard to believe. This will be my final educational recital. I know everybody has a lot to do this top part of the semester, so thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate it. This first tune was called Short Story. It was by a trumpeter named Kenny Dorham. And it's off of his off of Joe Henderson's album, Page One, from 1963. And Kenny Dorham is actually from Austin, Texas, fun fact. That's where I did my master's degree. Hook 'em horns, side note. I wanted to honor Joe Henderson with my recital tonight. He's somebody who's given me quite a bit of inspiration recently, creatively. And so I wanted to play a lot of tunes by him and also associated with him. So we have a really good lineup planned for tonight, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it quite a bit. We have Trenton Klaz on piano, Patrick Leavy on bass, and Rashaad Greene on drums. My name is Ian Henderson. This next tune we're going to play is called Blues on the Corner. It is by McCoy Tyner from the 1965 album The Real McCoy. And it's a 12-bar blues, and it's called Blues on the Corner because it's reminiscent of McCoy Tyner's childhood. He said he wrote it growing up in Philadelphia. He would always see a bunch of kids on the corner hanging out, hanging out, doing what kids do, and that's why it's called Blues on the Corner. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was, once again, Blues on the Corner. This next tune, Joe Henderson wrote when he was 15 years old. Pretty hard to believe. It showed up on the Joe Henderson Big Band album as Recuérdame, which means remember me in Spanish, but it's more commonly known as Recuérdame, which is in Portuguese, but it means the same thing. This arrangement is inspired by the arrangement that Joe Henderson did on his album Live at the Lighthouse from 1970 with Woody Shaw and George Cables as well. So I hope you guys enjoy Recuérdame.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Once again, that was Recorded on Me by the great Joe Henderson. This next tune we're going to play is called Serenity, which means peacefulness and calmness, which is funny because that's not the feeling I felt when I was shedding this tune. It has a 14-bar form, so it's a little irregular, and it has a nice mix of classic harmonies and some modern harmonies in there as well. This is from Joe Henderson's 1965 album, In and Out, Serenity.
Thank you.
That was Serenity, once again, by the great Joe Henderson. So Joe Henderson is one of the most well-known composers in jazz history. However, his compositional output pretty much stopped in 1970. There was a really prolific period there between 1963 and 1970 where he just wrote and wrote and wrote, and all these genius compositions came out. But then he also played a lot of jazz standards, later in his life, and he played each one of them like he wrote them. It really sounded like so original the way he played it that it really could have been one of his compositions. We're going to play one of those right now. It's called Ask Me Now by the great Thelonious Monk, first recorded on Thelonious Monk's Genius of Modern Music, number 2 from 1951. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Sadly, we have reached our last tune of the night. So that means it is time for our thank yous, and I have a long list of people to thank. First of all, I'd like to thank my band. A round of applause for them once again. Trent Klaz on piano. Patrick Leavy on bass. Rashaad Greene on drums. I'd like to thank Gusman's staff for working the event tonight. Thank you, Jay, and thank you, Diego, for being here, my boss. I'd like to thank my recital committee, John Hart, Marcus Strickland, Charles Bergeron, and Maricel Quevedo. I'd like to thank Marcus Strickland for giving me a new perspective on compositions, just improvisation, and just the history of Black American music in general. I would like to thank all of my friends at Frost, whether you're here tonight or if you watch the stream afterwards. I just want to thank you so much. You've made a very profound impact on me in a very short amount of time, and I love you all. I would like to thank, I'm going to change to Spanish because we have lots of friends and family in Latin America watching as well. Voy a cambiar a español. Me gustaría agradecer a mis suegros, Juan Carlos y Patricia, y mis cuñados. Me gustaría agradecer y saludar a mi familia de Argentina, Carlos y Andrea, y las chicas. Un abrazo fuerte. David and Saida. Saida era mi, she was my Spanish teacher, so she's the reason I know Spanish. Me gustaría agradecer o saludar a Josh Quinlan y Jorge Quintero. Un saludo. Mi familia en Colombia. Un abrazo grande para ustedes. And also affect English now. I'd like to thank my aunts and uncles and cousins who are all watching from different parts of the country, from Texas, from many different places. I would also like to thank my parents who are watching from home. Without them, I obviously wouldn't be able to do any of this. And I want to give a special shout out to my dad, who had a pretty bad health scare a few years ago. And there was a moment where we wasn't even sure if he was going to be able to listen to me play tonight or if he was going to make it at all. The doctors and the nurses, they all pronounced him a goner. And my mom frankly said she's not going to accept that. And she basically pulled him up by his bootstraps, made him get out of bed, start walking again, and nursed him back to health. So thank you, Mom, and thank you, Dad. And last but not least, I would like to thank, oh yeah, and my brother. I forgot about him. Weird. Hi, Alistair. Sorry, I forgot about you. And last but not least, I would like to thank my lovely and beautiful wife sitting right here, Maria Andrea. My greatest inspiration and really inspires me to be the best version of myself every day. It's a big cliche, I know, but if you find the right person, it's true. With that, we're going to finish off with a tune called The Sidewinder by Lee Morgan. This was recorded in 1964, and fun fact, it actually saved Blue Note Records from bankruptcy, basically. They were doing really, really badly. This was at a time when the Beatles were popular. Jimi Hendrix was first getting on the scene then, too. You had the Beach Boys around. This tune reached the Billboard Top 100 in 1965 as a jazz tune. It's pretty remarkable. Originally, Blue Note printed 4,000 copies of this album, and they obviously needed a lot more. This one is called Sidewinder. Also a fun fact, I was bitten by a venomous snake, and I lived to tell the tale, so this is a perfect tune for me. Thank you. and Rashaad Greene on drums. Thank you very much again. Y'all have a wonderful night.